Hey guys, this is Ben from Life in 360. Today I'm going to show you how to use the self timer on the Ricoh Theta camera here. And the self timer can be a good option when you don't want your smartphone to be in the shot. Normally we might be shooting wirelessly and we activate the Theta through our phone, which is a really handy tool, has a range of 10 meters, it's fantastic. However, this often means that the phone's actually in our photos, so we have to either hide it in our pocket or just have it in plain sight. So this is where the self timer comes in really handy. You can set up your shot, press the button, hide your phone, and then pose. So I'm going to show you how to use it. It's very easy. The first thing you'll want to do is update the firmware on your Theta camera. Now this is not done through your smartphone app. You'll have to plug it into your computer, either Mac or PC. You're going to have to head over to the Ricoh website and download the official Ricoh Theta program, which will allow you to update the firmware through there. Just go File, Firmware Update. This is an essential step because this option is not available with previous firmware updates. So once you've done that and followed the prompts, you turn your camera off and on again and you're ready to start shooting. So there's two ways to activate the self timer. The first way is through your smartphone. Okay, so we'll connect wirelessly to the camera as we normally would. And let's go into our Theta S app. So now you control the photo like you would any other photo. It's very simple. And what we want to do is press the top right button, which brings us into our shooting modes. And there it says shooting method. So we have a bunch of options here. There's normal shooting, interval shooting, which is for time lapses, a bunch of others. We want to hit self timer, which is the fourth option there. So once we press our button in the middle there, instead of it taking a photo straight away, it's going to give us 5 seconds. All right, I'm going to go ahead and hit that bad boy in the middle and we can hear it counting down. So now we have time to strike our pose. So that's a really good, easy way to do it if you want to do it through your phone. If you're on the move and you don't have time to connect your phone to your camera, then there's actually an easier way. The second way is to press the Wi-Fi button on the Theta there in the middle, and then you press on at the same time, and then you'll see the green light shows up, so we are now in self-timer mode. One thing about shooting 360 in public is that people stare at you like you're investigating aliens, so you must prepare for cold death stares everywhere you go. So we're going to press the shutter button, and then we have 5 seconds to put the camera down and strike our pose. And here we have it. There I am, hands-free. Put my phone in that pocket there. And that turned out really well. The self-timer method is really effective in adding to the mystery of how the photo was taken. Normally, if you're shooting wirelessly from your phone, the audience can tell you're probably doing something with your phone that's causing this 360 effect. If you can completely hide your smartphone, then it just kind of adds that extra wow factor about how the photo was taken. It also minimizes the presence of camera gear, which essentially you want to keep out of your photos as much as possible. Even if it's just a phone, you want to get rid of every last little detail that might be in your frame that doesn't look as good. So it's a really effective little tool. So I'd highly recommend updating your firmware and trying out the self timer. It's just a good way to kind of cover your tracks. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me on Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, or Facebook. If you own a 360 camera like the Ricoh here, you've probably heard of Tiny Planet Photography. I actually wrote a book about how to use a camera like this to achieve the most amazing Tiny Planet effects very quickly and easily, and all you need is a smartphone and a camera. So you might want to check that out. Until next time, keep living your life in 360, and I'll talk to you soon. 3, 2, 1. Man down, man down.